today reflects a significant change. Wayne Turner has been switched to number 10 to stiffen the Luton midfield after a spell of 6 league games without a win. Mal Donaghy is back in defence after missing last week's match at Coventry, and at number 8, top scorer Brian Steen marks his 200th league appearance. Southampton are able to recall Mick Mills, who was ineligible for their Milk Cup match on Wednesday. He replaces Nick Holmes, who has a rib injury. And if you include the injured Malcolm Waldron, Southampton have lost 6 of last season's team, which may help to explain why they haven't yet won away from home. But there's a return to Kenilworth Road for number 5 Chris Nicol, who between 1969 and 72 made 98 league appearances for Luton, one of the 4 clubs with which he's won promotion. Referee making sure there are 22 players on the field there, Kieran Barrett from Coventry. Southampton in blue start the match, playing from the right. Their formation from the kickoff suggesting that Mick Mills may be playing on the right to look after David Moss. Here's Armstrong. Mills, I think, encouraged to keep a very close watch on David Moss this afternoon. Indeed, Akbula more in the centre of the defence. And there's Danny Wallace going in. It's Brian Horton for Luton and Steen. Kirk Stevens at right back. And there's Wallace. The young players being pushed through now at the Dell. They've had to be in many ways. Danny Wallace with 3 goals to his credit so far this season. Walsh. Here's Steen. Little ball tucked back. It's a favourite Luton ploy, that, on the edge of the penalty area, but the touch has to be absolutely right. Goodyear. Akbula. Walsh. Still Moss, saved by Shilton. Beautifully set up by Paul Walsh, and David Moss, very adept from that sort of angle, holding off the challenge, but he's got to beat the England goalkeeper today. Side in the move. Well, we're over halfway through the first half, and it's lively, entertaining stuff. Nothing on the end of it up to now. Here's Akbula for Southampton. Roth. Orton. Good turn by Walsh. Steen. Brian Steen for Luton Town should have scored. A man who's put the ball in the net 12 times this season will look back on that chance and think, even with Peter Shilton in goal, there should have been no mistake. Lovely turn by Walsh, who put Steen in the clear. He had time, he had room, but they don't always go in. On your bad days, they go wide. Roth. Wallace. Oh, Danny Wallace! What a tremendous goal! 27 minutes gone, and Danny Wallace with an individual effort which Southampton have got every reason to acknowledge like that. Within a minute or two of Luton having a great chance at the other end, Wallace accelerating in from the left, saw his chance and drove that crisply into the far corner of the net. And Southampton take the lead. with Wallace's fourth goal of the season. Well, that's the way to finish. And here's Armstrong. Wallace is well forward again in this attack. Back to Mills. They've got two others in there too. Here's Wallace offside this time, but he's got the Southampton crowd who've travelled up from the south coast. Enthusiastic, and rightly so. It was a fine goal. Forward by Moss, here's Walsh. Horton just touched it on to Money. And here comes Hill. Southampton with their teeth well and truly in the match now. There goes Moran. It was a good ball by Williams, and Moran is clean through. And saved by the feet of Finlay. Moran, the top scorer. What a fine ball through by Steve Williams initially, which sent Moran in the clear. Plenty of time to think about it, perhaps too much time really. And Findlay, coming off his line, read the intentions and made the save with his feet. Fine through pass though by the Southampton captain. Well, Luton's normal accurate passing game seems to have got either bogged down here or else just subdued by a very keen Southampton side. Oh, well played, Moran. Oof, Wallace was in there, Castles is still in there with a chance, and he took it in the end. 5 minutes before half-time, Southampton have gone 2-0 up, and on the play, they deserve it. What a lovely little dummy by Steve Moran from that throw, and he worked it beautifully, didn't he? And when the chance seemed to have gone, it came to Castles, who even then he paused, but he paused for good reason, because when he hit it, it was in the roof of the net. Well, Castles has been going through a thin time of late, bit of pressure on him for his position from young David Puckett, and to score that goal may well help his confidence. As for Luton, it's 2 months since they won a home match in the First Division, and they're trailing here 2-0, having failed to find their touch in the first half. Steve Williams driving it forward, but there's been rather more purpose to Southampton than there has to Luton, and Steve Moran's little dummy there, worked from the throw-in, was a piece of skill that will be discussed, I'm sure, for a long time. Steen, the events possibly hinging on his miss when he was clean through, because after that Southampton took over. Danny Wallace gave them the lead a minute later with a splendid individual goal, and Keith Castles made it two as Luton's confidence drained and Southampton's increased. Jake Finlay, the Luton goalkeeper, was publicly blamed by his manager David Pleat after last week's defeat at Coventry for two of the goals. And I wouldn't think he was too happy with the second Southampton goal today, when there are rumours that Luton may be thinking of signing another keeper. Luton's last home win in the First Division was back on September the 18th, when they beat Brighton 5-0. 2-0 down here, after a recent run of six league games without a win. test of their confidence and their nerve following their promotion and that bright start they made. Here's Moss, they'll be hoping to turn the match in the second half. He's made a fair start too, Stevens had got well forward, and here's Ricky Hill, and he turned well against Wright and chipped one in to Shilton's arms. There's quite a lot of mist gathering around Kenilworth Road at the moment. Mills sees the chance to come forward, and he goes on now. Williams, it is on the ball, Mills here, and it's back for David Armstrong. You can see from that picture just how foggy it's become in the second half. Floodlights doing their best to pierce the gloom here at Kenilworth Road. But the English football winter is there for all to see. Money. Steen. Right. Hoofed forward by Williams. Stevens. Walsh. Oh, that's well played. Ricky Hill. There's a handball. Penalty. Handball seen conclusively by the referee, who didn't need a second look and has pointed to the spot. Ricky Hill got the ball out on the right. He drove it against Chris Nicol. And the referee had one look and said penalty. Now, how are they going to give the job back to Moss? They are. He gave it up a couple of months ago to Steen, but they've given the job back to David Moss. And he's missed it, and from the rebound it's been put in by Kirk Stevens. No, no, the referee has pointed. I think a linesman's flag says offside against another player. Stevens put the ball in the net, he remonstrates, but the flag was up, and I suspect another Luton player must have gone into an offside position as that ball ricocheted back off the woodwork from Moss's penalty. Offside, presumably. Stevens' effort chalked off, and it's still 2-0. No excitement here, but from Luton's point of view, no joy at the end of it, they're still two down. Turner. Oh, and Armstrong's had a chance to make it three, and he's gone wide of the goalkeeper and still hasn't got his shot in. Can Wallace? No. Well, the man who will be most relieved there is Goodyear, because Armstrong dispossessed him, and for a player of his quality had an easy chance to make it 3-0. He delayed and that chance went. To Stevens, into Hill. And Hill gets his shot in. Oh, what a fine goal! And just the tonic Luton were looking for. To beat Shilton from there, it has to be a good shot. And Ricky Hill provided just that. 64 minutes gone. Hill picking the ball up in his favourite position. Loosely call it inside right, if you like. He drifts across, looks up, sees the chance to drive one, and what a fine finish. Ricky Hill, who scored the last time Southampton came here, scores here to make it 2-1, and immediately Radi Antic comes on as substitute, and Luton take off Richard Money. And I would imagine the reorganisation there will be Wayne Turner to left back and Antic in the middle of the field. Williams, Wallace is coming in far side. On the chest of Walsh. Castles and Wallace to his left. Castles again. And Armstrong's coming in, he heads it back, but only to Finlay. Should have been three for Southampton there, surely. They had the extra man. Well, a match of many chances. Antich. Turner. And wide it goes to Moss. Typical Luton goal brings them level. The ball played wide to Moss. The cross was orthodox. Steen was challenged by Agboola, but the ball beat Shilton to his left. 69 minutes gone, 2-2, and how the match has turned. It could so easily have been 3-0 to Southampton. Instead, Luton are right back in it. Steve Williams. Southampton again have got three players pressed well forward looking for space. Wallace inside Stevens to Williams. But Luton have tightened up in the second half. And there goes Hill. This is Moran. Donaghy. Luton looking the stronger side now. Walsh. But if they were to overcommit forward, Southampton would punish them. Castles is in on Wallace's pass. Wallace is making ground. Oh. Well, he still battled back. Look at that from Castles. Mills. Armstrong, chance of a shot from him, left foot, it's in, David Armstrong. 6 minutes from time, Southampton are back in front, and Castles, an enormous amount of credit for him in the move. When the ball finally reached Armstrong, he made up for his earlier miss by burying that down to Finlay's left, and talk about finding the corner. That was a really beautiful shot. So Luton, in a sense, have got to start all over again. Here's Horton. Just one goal this time to make up. Hill. And again, it's that break out of defence. Moran with two coming in from the left. Going to provide a dramatic finish. There are only 4 minutes left of normal time. Agboola across. Not much time for stoppages, I would think, today. There hasn't been, the play doesn't seem to have stopped. Turner. That's a good ball. Stevens outside him, Ricky Hill. Goodyear, yes! Shilton's made a mistake, and Goodyear has scored. It's 3-3. Well, amazing. Walsh appeared to have the chance, it went. The ball came to Goodyear, he stabbed at it. Shilton didn't hold it, it trickled over the line. Well, everybody's human. So it looks after all like a point each. Oh dear me, Ricky Hill taken. Both was the offender there. Not vicious, just a bit late. Stoppage time now. Have Luton. Oh, he's going to book Roth. The third Southampton player to be cautioned. And in went Donaghy there. And the final whistle goes, the crowd Only 11,000 people, but my word, what entertainment they had. Peter Shilton disappointed perhaps at the end that the third goal went in against him. But what can you say? Southampton were 2-0 up, went on going forward, it got back to 2-2. Southampton in front again, and Luton finally level. A point apiece, but every player made his contribution. And it's wonderful, really, that two teams in the bottom five in the first division are prepared to come out and play like that and provide that sort of entertainment, which is just what the game in the current climate badly needs.